How's it going, everybody? My name's Avid, and today we are going to do another command block tutorial, specifically on the fill command, which if you're a builder in creative mode, the fill command is probably the most important command to know. Behind me is the bumblebee fight in my Crescent Bay boss room, and I use the fill command to create the entire honeycomb hive that you see here. I also use the fill command to fill in this incredibly deep lake, and I use the fill command here to create the clouds of Cloud's Rest, and even our quest hub we call the Citadel. So it goes without saying that the fill command is pretty darn important. So in this video, I'm going to show you all the ways that I use the fill command so that you can start using it in your adventure worlds. Let's get started. Before diving too deep into this video, I do recommend, if this is your first time working with command blocks, to take a look at my command block basics tutorial, which I'll link somewhere in this YouTube video, hopefully right now. So once you've gone and watched that video, or if you feel pretty confident with command blocks already, then you're ready to get started on the fill command. In this example, we're going to try out the very most basic version of the fill command, which is that I want to place blocks between this red piece of wool and that red wool up there. So I have a command ready to go, which is slash fill. That's our fill command. And then I have the coordinates of both blocks already written down here. And we can choose to fill a square or rectangular area with any block that we'd like. So in this case, let's do white stained glass. And now we can see that that entire area has been filled in. So that is the absolute most basic way to work with the fill command, is if you want to fill in a rectangular area. And at least in my experience, this is where a lot of tutorials end. And in my opinion, that is such a travesty, because the fill command can do so much more than just fill in blocks. Here, let me show you. There are extra commands that can be filled in after you enter in the fill command, and I'm gonna go through these five and how they work. So the destroy command is really interesting, and it will actually mine the blocks and place the blocks on the ground. So here's what I mean by that. So notice we've taken all of the red wool and we've replaced it with white stained glass, and then all of the wool is actually placed on the ground. So the next two augments of the fill command are outline and hollow. And while they are very similar, they have one major difference. So they're both really great for making hallways or really hollow spaces, because what they'll do is they're gonna fill in the outline of these two blocks that I have here, this lower red block and this upper red wool block. The hollow command will fill the interior of that space with air blocks always. So that means anything that you want that's important in the middle of your fill region, if you want to keep that, use the outline command. And especially for messages as important as this one, obviously we wouldn't ever want to get rid of that. Jokes aside, let's take a look at what we're working with here. So we want to make a hallway between these two blocks. So let's go ahead and get that command ready. We're going to make a blue wool hallway, and we're going to specify outline. So that means that every block on the interior is kept intact. The hollow command is great for if you're trying to make a hole through a mountain, or you're trying to make a hallway inside of a mountain, because what's normally going to happen is you're going to have a ton of stone and andesite and blocks, and you want to be able to punch through the mountain. So the hollow command is a great way to do that. And the next augment of the fill command is the keep augment. And the way that this works is it will only fill in blocks in the specified area if those blocks are air blocks, like this one that we have here. Now this, as it stands, would fill the entire column with blue wool, but if I say keep, it's only gonna fill in that little space right there. So the last augment of the fill command also happens to be the most important one, which is the replace augment. The way this works is we can specify a block that we want to replace with another block in an area. If we wanted to replace this black wool block with a blue wool block, we could simply run the command where we fill in that area with blue wool, and after that we type replace. And then we're allowed to enter in a new variable here, which is the material that we are going to replace, or the block that we're going to replace. So let's go ahead and type in black wool. And when we run this command, you'll notice that the black wool is changed into blue wool. In fact, this command is so important, I use this so often, we should go on a field trip. So we're at the Dwarven Mines of Ebonglade. This is a two-player puzzle dungeon in my adventure map series. And we have two dwarves outside of this dungeon that guard the entrance. Now the dwarf on the right, I'm not totally thrilled about using polished diorite, and so I'd like to replace all of the polished diorite with gold. So I've gone ahead and queued up a command here. If I want to replace all of that diorite, I would start by typing in gold. And now be really careful, because if you execute this command right now, you would replace the entire dwarf with gold blocks, and you'd have this giant golden rectangle that would look terrible, and you'd be really sad about losing all of your work. So make sure you type replace here. And then we're going to tell the game to replace all of the polished diorite on the dwarf. So here we go. Wow, he looks a lot better. Did you know that you can also replace multiple types of blocks with the replace command? Check this out. So if I wanted to replace this entire column, which is built up of a bunch of different stone types, and I wanted to turn that column into a gold block, I could use the replace command and use this hashtag stone ore replaceables. And all of the blocks that are considered stone ore replaceables are replaced with gold, and ones that are not are left intact. Okay, we've done the basics. Now let's try out something really cool, which I call using your character as a paintbrush. How does this work exactly? Well, with a repeating command block, you can do something like this, where you can say execute at the nearest player, or you could say a player in creative mode or a player with a certain tag, and you run the fill command continuously around the player. And you're going to just fill in that area with some block. In this case, I'm filling all of the blocks beneath the player in a 2x2 or 3x3 roughly radius using the fill command, our favorite command now. And I have some white snow that fills in below me, and when I jump, it follows me around. And now you might start to get an idea of how you could make some kind of parkour map, or maybe even a special ability that you could give to your players if they have a certain item in their hand. And you can start to see how easy it is to use yourself to paint with the fill command. So you're probably asking yourself, what are some other things that you can do with the fill command? And my answer to that always will be, you can do everything with the fill command. Here's another idea that I just came up with called the Tunnel of Love, or at least that's what I'm calling it. And what we're gonna do is we're going to replace every color in this with the color behind it to make it look like the tunnel is moving forward. So if I just go here and flip this lever, yes! So as you can tell, there are so many different ways to use the fill command, especially with the power of replace, to make your worlds come alive. As you can see here, this is essentially an animation that's happening by way of the replace command. I hope you guys get an idea of how to use the fill command. Of course, there are always so many more things that you can do with it, but this is just a subset of those ideas. If you want to see more ideas about how to use the fill command, please let me know down in the comments. I'd love to hear it. Well, that'll just about do it for today, folks. I want to thank you so much for sticking around to the end of the video. If you liked this content, I'd really appreciate if you hit the like button down below. And if you want to see more of this content in the future, please hit that subscribe button. It helps out a whole lot. I'm trying to think of more commands that would be interesting and useful in your adventure maps. If you have any ideas, let me know of the next command that you'd like me to cover. Thank you so much for stopping by. Bye-bye.